Now that we have created our activities list, the next challenge is to come up with the order in which these activities have to be performed, for which we need to arrange these activities in a logical sequence from start till end. And to do that, we need to find out the linkages between these activities as well as determining the dependencies. Each activity in the activity list should have at least one predecessor and one successor, except the first and the last activity. When it comes to sequencing, we have number of ways. We can do it using the project management information system or a computer software, such as MS Project, Primavera, CA Clarity, Basecamp, etc. It can also be done manually using sticky notes to post them on the wall or the whiteboard, or blended approach can be used, combining the computer software as well as the manual approach. In this process, our first focus is that we should be able to convert the list of activities into network diagram that will set the base for our schedule baseline. Let us have a look at the ITTOs of this process. Among inputs, we have the project management plan, part of which is the schedule management plan and the scope baseline. Then we have project documents, part of which is the activity list, which is the prime input here. Then we have assumptions log, milestone list, as well as enterprise environmental factors and organizational process assets. Among tools and techniques, we have precedence diagramming method, which we are going to look into detail in the coming lectures. Similarly, dependencies determination as well, we will see in the next lecture. And then we have leads and lags and the project management information system. And among the outputs, we have the project schedule network diagram. And we will update various documents such as the activity list, milestone chart, assumption log, as well as activity attributes. I see we are doing great progress here. See you in the next lecture.